Birds are living dinosaurs, and that shift is one of the most spectacular transitions in the history of life. This year, researchers studying both fossils and modern birds figured out how one group of dinosaurs became smaller, more adaptable. The change happened pretty quickly, setting the stage for the avian explosion, the arrival of modern birds. Think Frankenstein meets the Fountain of Youth. Researchers stitched two mice together, one young, one old, and connected their circulatory systems. The connection rejuvenated the brain and the muscle of the older mouse. It appears young blood contains a factor that can turn back the clock on the aging process. This year, several teams showed that robots, like people, can accomplish more by working together. In one study, 1,000 robots, each the size of an American quarter, joined together like a marching band to form squares and letters and shapes. Another team, inspired by termites, designed a robot swarm that built three-dimensional structures. Researchers who make computer chips are breaking from their old ways. In 2014, they created the first large-scale neuromorphic chips. These chips are designed to process information in ways that are more like a living brain. The chips could make it easier for machines to carry out perceptual tasks, such as vision. And more capable robots could also deal with a lot of data from sophisticated environmental sensors. Scientists who work with stem cells have reached a long-sought goal. They turned human stem cells into pancreatic beta cells that can secrete insulin. These important cells are missing in people who have type 1 diabetes. But doctors can't yet transplant the new cells into patients. That's because the cells would be rejected as foreign. Still, the achievement brings a possible treatment for diabetes one step closer. When it comes to ancient cave art, researchers have long believed that Europe held the world's oldest examples. But this year, researchers announced that a cave in Indonesia holds handprints and paintings that they believe are 35,000 years old. The find suggests that modern humans were pretty creative by the time they left Africa and began settling the rest of the world. In 2013, brain scientists made a cool but kind of creepy discovery. They could instill a fake memory of fear in mice. To do it, they manipulated neurons with light. And this year, they took the method one step further. They used a similar technique to switch good memories to fearful ones, and bad memories to more pleasant recollections. In 2014, researchers launched a record number of CubeSats into space. A CubeSat is a pint-sized, low-cost satellite. But they're starting to do some real science. They're cheap and easy to launch, and they can carry very powerful sensors. That means in time, constellations of CubeSats may do the job that now takes a single, complex, and pricey mission. The DNA code usually includes just four letters: G, C, A, and T. But this year, researchers added a new pair of letters, X and Y. And they managed to insert these extra letters into living bacteria. Next up, they want to use the extra DNA letters to code for amino acids that are not normally part of the proteins that organisms make. And now, the breakthrough of the year. That is the sound of a comet. It was recorded by the Rosetta spacecraft. In August, after a 10-year journey, Rosetta became the first probe to orbit a comet. Then, in November, it made history again, dropping a small lander that drifted to the comet's surface. But the landing was awkward. It bounced and ended up in a place where it couldn't recharge its solar panels. Still, it collected a lot of data before its batteries ran out. Now, Rosetta is chasing the comet. It's going to watch its jets of gas and dust turn on as the comet nears the sun. The results could tell scientists a lot about how our solar system formed and what brought water to Earth.